here to offer my and our organization's unequivocal support to John Smith. A few press reports have emerged which have carried as yet alleged and unproven stories about John Smith having engaged in sexual misconduct with two female employees of this organization. While the matter is sub judice and I'm not at liberty to speak about the individuals involved, I would like to place on record our wholehearted support in ensuring that right is done. As a legal counsel and representative to John Smith, appointed by the organization, let me put this forward. John Smith is not guilty. He is innocent. I would like to put in front of you some facts which will help put some light on the situation. About 10 months ago, the organization floated an idea wherein two people from this organization would be selected to represent our organization at a foreign office. We received a large number of applications, and two of those applications happened to be from these two female employees. John Smith was heading the committee that would scrutinize and recommend the applications and the people who would go abroad. It was a tremendous pressure work environment. He had to deal with a lot of solicitations, sometimes amounting to threats. But I will say that John Smith carried out his job in line with the regulations as laid out by the organization and within the rules as stipulated by the requirements of this position. Around 4 months ago, a few employees approached John Smith with the intent of pressing their case, in which John Smith had to reply back that although he is a member of the committee, it will be ultimately the committee that will decide. During the course of one of those conversations, things got heated, and I would admit that John Smith lost his cool. And he may have something that he deeply regrets. It was said to the audience as a whole, and these two female employees happened to be a part of that audience. The two female employees have taken an affront to that particular remark and made it look like a sexual misconduct charge. It may be noted, there were other female employees present in the room, not one of whom has come forward and reported charges of a similar nature. My own independent inquiry into this whole episode has revealed that John Smith, apart from that one particular comment, did not, and at no stage did he indicate a preference for any particular employee or a group of employees. I will take questions later. Thank you so very much. I will also say that once the results were announced, he received a lot of feedback. He received a lot of criticism because apparently in many people's eyes, not the right candidates were selected. Let me assure you that we selected the right candidates and that they were selected in accordance with the rules and regulations as laid out by the organization and the rules of this program. In this moment, in this difficult moment for John Smith and his family, I again reiterate that I, as his legal counsel, stand firmly behind his convictions. I stand firmly behind the career that he has made. He has worked for this organization for 11 years. There, it is an unblemished record for 11 years. Right from the time when he started off as an associate to the time now when he is senior vice president special projects, there has not been one instance when such baseless charges have been brought against him. to drive my point home, here is what John Smith has to say. Once this is over and he is proved innocent, John Smith is going to file a defamation case of ₹100. Please note, of ₹100 on the two female employees. The intent is not to threaten or to intimidate, but to make a symbolic gesture that such sort of frivolous lawsuits should not be entertained. John Smith is and remains an innocent man, and I would request you all not to hold a trial by media to frame him in a particular light. With that, I am ready to take questions. We can take questions now. Any questions? Yes, Sarthak.
Okay. So wonderfully, wonderful defense of Mr. John Smith put up by you, sir. I would just like to ask, how are you pronouncing him not guilty before any inquiry is conducted into the allegations?
So I am pronounced.
You are jumping the gun. You are asking for not to hold a media trial, but in a way you are doing the same thing without any proper investigation. How are you getting about it?
I would like to take you back and take your attention back to my speech, wherein I said that an internal inquiry was conducted in which he was found guilty. However, some new allegations came up and we are now trying to disprove that. Per the tenets of that internal inquiry, I am saying that he is not guilty. I hope that answers your questions. Yes.
In your speech, you said that as per my inquiry, he is not guilty. So it's a very serious case and there must be some external agency should be hired and then results should come out. Till then, how can you declare that it is not?
Excellent question. The internal inquiry was of course limited to the internal employees of the organization. But I get your point. This new inquiry that has been constituted is an external inquiry and it will be and as you will see, he will be pronounced not guilty there as well. Any other questions? Well, on that note, again, I would like to say that John Smith is a respected employee. He's a respected corporate citizen. And I would request you to cease and desist any tirade against him. Thank you. Back to you.